Hi, and welcome to episode 3 of Listen Up, a show produced by Television Production 2 students. I'm Kyle Maloney. On Friday, November 17th, and Saturday, November 18th, SCW will be presenting Henry, episode 4, A New Hope. Sarah Bourget got the privilege of getting a preview. Let's take a look.
The show is about two kingdoms placed in medieval times, and it's a very serious situation where these two kingdoms are at war, but Prince Hal, who is the prince of the empire, decides he wants to cosplay and live his own childish dreams, and he somehow manages to suck all of his business with all of his cosplayer friends into the giant war.
Theater means I can build more vivid friendships with my friends while striving to become a better performer.
It's basically a way for me to be who I want to be without like anyone really judging me, because like we're all different here, and I also get to pursue the dreams that I want to do, and on top of that I meet some like really cool people.
We will be right back with MHS sports coverage after these public service announcements produced by Television Production 1 students. Emily Parziale, Tristen Gomes, Julian Hashem, Mia Bennett, and Evan Parker.
Hey.
Hey.
What are you doing this weekend?
Well, I found this nice book.
You won't be needing that. Hang out with me and my friends this weekend.
Okay.
I'll text you the details. Oh, and wear something cute.
Hi, guys. We're giving you a makeover.
Hey, what's that app?
Oh, it's an app where, like, if you share the link with people, like, on your story or send it to people, they can swipe up and comment things anonymously.
Should I get it?
Yeah, definitely. Everyone has it. It's so fun.
Okay, bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Thank you.
On Friday, October 13th, the varsity girls volleyball team had a great win versus Wareham in the MHS gym after school. Nicky Hart had the chance to make a highlight of the game. On October 23rd, the girls' volleyball team played against Pembroke. Gil Araujo made a highlight of the game. Let's check it out. The boys' varsity soccer team had an incredible regular season. I was able to put together a highlight of their game on October 23rd.
And now that we're playing a little bit more sound defense, we're going to make sure we no through balls, give them a little bit of a...
Six and right on three!
One, two, three, six and right!
Let's go, boys! Already the show goes on all night. Till the morning we dream so long. Anybody ever wonder when they would see the thunder? Just remember when you come up.
All on your soul and put whips up on your back. They be lying through their teeth. Hope you slip up off your path. I don't switch up, I just laugh. Put my kicks up on they desk, unaffected by they threats. Then get busy on they ass. See, that's how that shit tell me, man. That's how my daddy raised me. That glittering may not be gold. Don't let nobody play me. If you are my homeboy, you never have to pay me. Go on and put your hands up. When times is hard, you stand up. L-U-P the man, cause a brand that the fans trust. So even if they ban us, they'll never slow my plans up.
The varsity boys soccer team has recently made it to the tournament. Courtney Roberts got the chance to speak with some of the players and the coach. Here's her news story.
I think for any program, it takes a little while for it to develop over time. And I think that like having 4 years now, these have been guys that have been in the program for 4 years. I think there's a certain level of buy-in. They're really melding together as a team. We have a lot of kids who just who want to be there and want to work hard and want to be successful.
We're putting in the work right now. We could potentially get somewhere in tournament, but we're going to be facing one of the hardest teams right off the start because we're a low seed. So it'll be a challenge, but I think we can do it.
Now we're spending less time focused on basic skills, more time working on formations and like more strategy so that we can be more competitive in games.
I think this year we've had a lot more practices. We've worked a lot harder for it, and I think our team like gets along better. We're kind of on the same sync.
I think that really we have the ability to compete with anyone.
We focused a lot more on ball handling and more skill training instead of conditioning.
But we do have a pretty good amount of underclassmen. So I think it's going to be really beneficial for us. I think that sophomore class has a really lot of talented kids who are really ready to even step up to varsity and contribute at a higher level.
This year we've had new players. We've been working a lot harder. We've tried out new strategies. So I'm hoping all of those lead to more success.
We had a lot of kids that stepped up this year. We had Nick Ramos come on the team, who wasn't on before. We had some good freshmen that joined the team, and everybody actually had passion this year, which was really good.
Having a lot of youth is never a bad thing. So I think as we continue to get more and more numbers, we'll continue to have success.
I'm pretty excited, like the rest of my team, to make it to tournament. I think we'll do okay, but we'll probably get placed against like one of the harder teams when we start. So I don't know how well we'll do, but I'm hoping we do good.
I mean, Norwell last year was the top ranked team, and they went all the way to the finals of the D3 tournament. And this year, you know, we managed to tie them at home. So I really think that our ability to hang with a team like Norwell is really a positive sign that, I mean, we can play with anybody. So I think if we just continue to practice and play the way that we've been doing this whole time, that no matter who we face, we're going to have, it's going to be a really tough game, and the guys are going to play a game that we can be proud of, and hopefully we get the result that we're aiming for.
Good luck to the boys' soccer team who play at Dover Sherbourne on Saturday, November 4th for their first playoff game. This is Courtney Roberts from Listen Up.
The boys' basketball season is right around the corner. How will the team do? Here's a preview. Last year, Middleborough High School made a real strong push for the tournament. This year, they're looking to build on that. We got a few interviews inside a Middleborough High School basketball open gym. Let's go take a look.
My goal for my sophomore year, have as much fun as possible, be out there with people that I love playing with, you know. I hope it's pretty good. Probably have a fun experience.
I attended Carlos Palmer High School for my freshman year, and I recently transferred back to Middleborough in the late spring or early summer, and the basketball program for Middleborough welcomed me back to them, and I feel right back at home and fitted back as a family for Middleborough basketball.
Open gyms happen every Monday and Wednesday here at the high school. Me personally, I have unfortunately, because of football, as much as I begged Coach to let me participate, he said that he wanted me not to get injured in light of us making the tournament for football.
I think a lot of kids in the team have seen a lot of improvement individually and as a group. And, you know, as strange as this may sound, I mean, we're hoping to make the tournament. I mean, at least 10 games, make the tournament, be competitive in every game we play.
Well, I've got a personal goal and I've got a team goal, and our team goal is to make tournament. I truly, truly believe we have a group of kids this year that can really do it.
Don't forget, tryouts are the Monday after Thanksgiving. We hope to see you there. This has been Kaya Maloney from Listen Up. Up next, Declan Hastings brings us Inside TV Pro, and Matt DeRosiers gives us an update on the class of 2020. But first, let's watch some more PSAs produced by Aileen, Peddie, Eden, Eugenio, Mandi, Bukunt, and Ryan Franey.
Thank you. don't you have a drink?
I'm okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's fine.
Dude, but it's not so a big good. Deal.
I don't know.
Come on, just try some.
Everyone does it.
I don't really want to.
Loser.
Come on, just try one and watch
me. Yeah, just do it.
Maybe just one.
I know I'm interrupting your very important television program, but I need to tell you something. Something important. This is something you must hear, and hopefully this information will go on to save lives. It could be you.
This is so boring. I don't need to worry about this, because no one I know has a mental illness. This doesn't apply to me. I'm gonna go get something to eat. Whoa, dude, are you okay?
Just leave me alone.
Could be you. Every year, hundreds of people fall victim to mental illnesses like depression, psychopathy, and many more. Why they do it is the real problem. These people could come from an abusive home life, a gang they had to join just to survive, suffer from a mental illness, or many other factors. Did you know that 1% of the general population in America show high psychopathic traits, or are psychopaths? That may not sound like a lot, but when you consider that there are 323 million people living in the US alone, that's around 3.2 million people that are or have a high chance of becoming a psychopath, and that's just one mental illness alone. That's why we need more mental hospitals to help these people who have mental illnesses and prevent them from doing bad things in the future. I'm not asking you to help, I'm telling you.
Television production is a four-year class for the students of MHS. Students learn how to record videos, edit, and conduct interviews throughout their experience. All of these skills contribute to the videos they produce for the MOVE contest, where students can enter videos where they can win awards. Declan Hastings created a story focused on everything that happens in TV Pro. Give me your, attention, baby.
I gotta tell you a little something about yourself. TV Pro is a class where we learn how to edit and shoot videos like Move and sports films.
Right now, I'm working on a news story. But, you know, others, you know, they have like a highlight or maybe they're working on a Move video.
At school committee meetings, we set up all the microphones and the tables, and we make sure all the audio and lighting is set up good so that it will work the next day.
Well, I used to do like videos for fun with my friends and make like a special project video for it. And we've always had fun to do it, and this was like a great segue to making it a bigger thing and actually knowing like the right way to do it. So if you're interested in that, TV Pro is great for you.
Move is a video competition that our school attends, and basically we all like produce videos throughout the year, like news stories, documentaries, short films, and some of us will get selected to like have our videos be shown. And what it is we go on a field trip to Patriot Place in Foxborough, and we compete against other schools in our area, and our videos get shown on the movie screen, and then we win like awards, and I don't know, it's a fun time, I guess.
TV Pro has so far given me good experience because my classmates are very helpful, and it's just a great life skill to get to know.
Matt DeRosiers interviewed the class of 2020 board to see what they've done so far and what they have planned for the future. Let's check it out.
We've participated in the Middleborough Crazy Days in August, and we made a ton of money off that, and we sold like customized apparel like socks, pop sockets, and headbands, and we also sold raffles, and it's basically it. But that was a good amount of money we made. That was about like $2,500, $3,000.
Some of the challenges we've had so far as a class board was when we started off the year and we didn't really have much money to work with, so we just did little fundraisers and we got a lot more money, and then we're starting to do bigger fundraisers, and that's what we're hoping to do.
At our meetings, we talk about events that we want to do, events that are happening, and events that are going to happen soon.
In the future, I like us to have a lot of money so we can have like really nice future events. I'm looking at the camera, sorry. And just to maybe be more cohesive as a class. Like, I don't know if we can do that, but it'd be nice, you know.
Thanks for joining us for the fourth episode of Listen Up for the 2017-2018 school year. If you missed part of the show or would like to watch us again, check us out online at middleboroughtv.com. You can also follow us on Twitter and Facebook at @middleboroughtv. We will see you in a few weeks. From all of us in Television Production 2, I'm Kyle Maloney, and have a great day.